can be seated. Let's pray together. Eternal God, our Creator and Creator of marriage, be here today. We know you're here today. Not only bring your joy to this wedding, but to the marriage and his family as well. In favor, look upon Chris and Becky and their kids and grant that they may lead a long and happy life together. Until we all meet at the great wedding feast that has no end. In Jesus' name. What a great day. We're gathered here today, and it's a great day. Because we have family and we have friends, and we're all witnessing something that is great. Something that God has created for us from the very beginning. And that's what we're here to do. Jeremiah 29:11 starts this way. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you. And not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all of your heart. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. God reassures us when he follows up these awesome words. He says, plans to prosper you. To harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. At the beginning of marriage, what better thoughts and feelings can there be than those of prosperity? That has nothing to do with money. And those of hope and those of a future. Not dwelling on the past and its mistakes, but realizing that the future is a new opportunity, and I think that's why we're here today. We're here in God as our ultimate witness that audience of one making this right before his eyes. And that's what God has in store for you, both of you and your family. He's promised this to you, and our God keeps his promises, which he's demonstrated over and over again, hasn't he? Perhaps you've seen some of the billboards that have appeared around major cities over the last few years. There are these black billboards with white writing, and it's real simple, and simple messages from God. One is, have you read my number one bestseller? There will be a test. God. Others say things like, my way is the highway. God. The one that was sure to grab the attention of a lot of people said, love the wedding, invite me to the marriage. God. And today I just want to share a few thoughts about inviting God into this marriage relationship. It makes a difference. And it's how God builds a marriage. First of all, he builds it when he created the first relationship. And by the way, in Genesis 1, when it says everything was good, he created stuff on the first day, and the second day, and the third day, and fourth day, fifth day, it was all good. Second day, created man, it was very good. And man, you know, could get puffed up by that and think, you know, I'm very good. But what happens is the very next day, after he rests, he says, it's not good for man to be alone. So the first thing that he created was very good. Then there was a not good situation, and it was remedied by creating a relationship, creating woman. And that is our first covenant relationship. And covenant is such a strong word, but what it means is a whole lot more than contract. It means a whole lot more than the signing of ink and names on a piece of paper that says, hey, we're married. Covenant means this is the no matter what part of a relationship. I chose you. I honor you. I will work through anything. I will never give up. This is a covenant made between us and God. So God builds a marriage by creating covenant. Second thing is, he builds a marriage by offering his grace to us when we need it. But what he wants us to do is share that grace with each other. I mean, this is just really a way of saying that we follow God's model of grace-giving in everything we do, and it's the no-strings-attached kind of grace and kind of love. Well, the third thing on how he builds a marriage is that he encourages us to empower each other. to outdo each other by showing love. What a concept. I mean, it basically means I'm married to you and everything I do is about making you better. Everything I do is about making you better. I shower praise. I shout admiration. I can't get enough of giving blessings. Nothing gets in the way of our relationship, and that empowers each other. And then the fourth thing is intimacy. It's amazing how close we are, emotionally, psychologically, spiritually. We communicate, and nothing gets in the way of that either. We're close, because God has been invited in. We're going to share our vows, exchange our rings, make a memory, and we'll call it a day. Becky, you're going to go first with your vows.
Christopher, I take you to be my husband, I desire to be trustworthy as your wife and to love you in all circumstances. I promise to be faithful to you, love you, support you, and lend you faith for all of your dreams. I will cherish and respect you all of the days of our lives together. Starting anew once again, I give thanks that I have found you. May our marriage be a gift to the world and our families, as your love has been a gift to me. I promise to be a loving mother to our children. I promise to be their strength and their emotional support, loving them with all of my heart forever. I give you this ring to wear with love and joy as I invite you to share in my life. I praise God that today His will is being fulfilled. I praise Him for you, for all of your love, and for your friendship.
So throughout life, no matter what may lie ahead of us, I pledge my life to a loving, faithful husband.
And we have rings as a symbol of that commitment. Becky, we'll begin with you. You can just repeat it.
Okay.
Chris, I offer this ring to you.
Chris, I offer this ring to you.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And the vows we have just spoken.
And the vows we have just spoken.
Becky, I offer this ring to you.
Becky, I offer this ring to you.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And the vows we have just spoken.
And the vows we have just spoken.
At this time, Chris and Becky and their family want to create a memory. And what they're going to do is gather around that table and make a sand sculpture together.
Oh, Lord. share them with you for Becky and Chris and their family on this special day. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. And let the peace of Christ rule in your heart.
I have an announcement to make. Inasmuch as the two of you have agreed on this day, husband and wife, declared your love for each other by these vows, by the joining of your hands, by the giving of the rings, and the making of that memory, that sculpture. I now declare you to be husband and wife. And then, as the word says, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Congratulations. Chris, kiss your mommy.
Woo-hoo!
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you, you can walk out. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Chris. What is it again?
Struck.
Struck. Mrs. Chris.
I know. That's too cute.
Chris and Becky wanted me to make an announcement while we're all here before you get visiting with them out there and at the reception. If you're planning on going to the reception, it's going to be at Fans Grill, Sports Grill. It's still called Will's on the sign. It's not changed to Fans yet, but it's at the location where you were given directions to. So just in case you get there and you wonder why it's not called Fans, it's still called Will's. So they wanted me to make that announcement and invite you all there. So you are dismissed.
Have a second.
Yeah.
But I think you did a really good job. And what did you think of the wedding?
Yeah.
It was beautiful, wasn't it?
You did a great job, Jen.
And your dad did a great job, too.
Okay. Oh, you did a great job. You did a great job.
I knew you would. I knew you would.
My life seems to be in cycles of about 15 years. I can't remember the different cycles in order.
So you're just a year younger than Sheila.
I think Sheila's a couple years older.
Oh, she'll be 67. You just turned 65.
Yeah, I turned 65 for sure.
Oh, wow.
She's a lot older than I am.
Older.
Yeah.
No, not even like
How's business?
Alright.
You want to come do bubbles, baby?
For these times?
Yeah. It's...
Oh, God, I'm going to slow down.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, don't
stand
on this side.
Turn around.
Camera back.
Thank you.
Is this your camera?
Yeah, Larry's in mine. Yeah. And she didn't know I was doing this, and neither do you, but I'm about to tell you now. When y'all were up there, I got real good close-ups of you. And you look just divine.
That's what I did last week.
He went to get the CD.
Okay. Hi, Lair.
Beautiful.
Sheila, you want to say something to them?
Hello. I'm freezing out here, girl.
Freezing? It's not cold out here.
It is to me.
Hi. This is for Becky and Christopher.
Hi, Becky.
What would you like to say?
Congratulations. Yeah, I'm so happy for you.
They're sweet, aren't they? Beautiful. Hi, y'all.
Hey, Chris and Becky.
What would you like to say to
congratulations.
How are you guys?
Becky, Chris, congratulations.
Give them
good luck here.
Yes, good luck.
There you go. There you go. Okay, hi, how are you?
Hi, good.
Good, good. You want to say anything to Becky and Christopher?
I'm just so happy for them. Hope they'll be happy for a long time.
That's wonderful. What would y'all like to say to Becky and Christopher?
Congratulations.
Yay. Thank you. Hey, would you like to say something to Becky and Christopher?
Congratulations, you guys.
Yay. Okay. Becky and Christopher?
Congratulations, guys.
Becky and Christopher?
Good luck. Congratulations.
Ah, wonderful. And yourself?
Congratulations. God bless you.
Ah, you're sweet.
Congratulations. Have a wonderful marriage. And we're here for the party.
Yay. Yeah, what about you guys?
Congratulations, Chris and Becky. I know you're going to have a wonderful life together. I look forward to sharing a happy moments with you.
I'll go look at that. Thank you.
It's about time.
All right, we're all set up.
Maybe you can help arrange us, Jim.
Well, right there looks good. No, I'm just kidding.
My sunglasses are on my head.
Oh, yeah. One, two, three.
Oh, yeah.
That's funny.
One, two, three. Tricky, that
one. Funny one? Yeah, everybody make a funny face.
This is the funny face one?
Funny face, ready?
Okay, funny face. Ready, one, two, three.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh. One, two, three. Let's get up here. Call it. Yeah, cool. Gotta send those to my mom.
Now the guy, yeah.
One, two, three.
It looks so serious, right?
After three.
Walk up and around
the
room.
Maybe
we just throw it
up. Is
that good? Oh, I'm gonna rip it off.
That's
tonight. No.
Okay, you guys ready?
One,
two, three.
That's a good one.
Now what?
I
know,
I'm just
directed. You're a good director, though.
Should we just do a big group one? You guys, are you individual shots?
No.
Okay, just
YouTube,
right here.
How do I hold your hand, or are you?
First time meeting you guys.
What do you have?
Here, put your hand out here. Take, there, take that.
Put your flowers down.
Oh, yeah. Okay, thank you so much.
Amy, Yeah, have a good experience.
Alrighty.
Somebody can push the button. Come on.
So what are we doing now?
Now they're doing pictures with Becky's family.
Let me.
I don't know if you can see that. Hi, Debbie. You better let them.
This is going to be a fun video for y'all.
Yeah, you're the only one taking it.
Now. So anything you say can and will.
Uh-oh. I didn't notice that.
What?
Filming. Yeah. I don't think I said anything.
Can you see through that thing, Deb?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're
fine. You need a stool?
I got it.
I don't really.
Okay.
Ready, 1, 2, 3.
That was good.
Do another one.
Okay, ready? Okay. She's going to go and then I'm going to go. Okay, ready? Here we go. Oh, Becky, you moved ready.
Sorry.
It's okay. 1, 2, 3. This is a cool camera.
All going up to take a picture.
There you go.
Are you gonna put mom out? Too short.
Here, I'll switch with your mom.
Yeah, why don't you come down here, Mom?
Okay.
And I'll stand behind the boys here, kind of like. There.
We got a
place. Yeah,
back.
There you go.
We'll have to put you with the kids.
This is the closest. Oh, look at that. All right.
Hey, Jim, we want one with you, Becky and I and you.
That'll work.
We're good. Yeah.
All right.
Jeez.
She's not even nervous.
About Becky and Chris, like we wish you the very best.
Hopefully they have a good life. Hopefully they stay together.
Okay, just remember this is videotape. It will be on here forever. Whatever you say will be on here forever.
I love you, Slim.
Yes, me too. It's got wine, cups, corner seat.
Cool.
TV.
Wow.
Speakers.
Yeah. I want to say about Chris and Becky.
Love them.
Reception, okay.
Hi.
Named Will.
Yes.
I think I got it all. Big smooch.
Yeah. You once inside the limo. There you go. Little hearts are going. So you want to say something to Becky and Chris and Ida?
Have a happy life. God bless you both.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Congratulations.
Hi, y'all.
Everybody's good.
Go ahead. You're on.
Congratulations.
Job well done. The food's delicious.
That's funny. And you guys?
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, thank you for the meal.
You're live.
Thank you for the food. Just smile and say hi. Okay.
1, 2, 3. Tomorrow!
Oh, that's wonderful. Thank you, y'all.
She'll get it.
Sure.
Excellent.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Would y'all like to say something to Becky and Chris?
Congratulations.
Okay. Good. Okay. You want to say something to Becky and Chris?
No.
No? Say something to Becky and Chris?
No.
Hi.
Okay. Okay. Tell me, Dad, you want to say something to Becky and Chris?
Perfect timing.
That's not really good food. They did a toast in there.
Oh, did they do a toast in there?
Yeah. Okay. Y'all want to say anything?
To Becky and Chris? What do you want to say to Becky and Chris? Yeah, I didn't. Work hard at loving each other. Make it last.
Bob?
Sheila speaks for me. I'm your Sheila's husband.
Oh. Yeah.
Congratulations, you two.
Is there anything or anyone you would like me to videotape?
You know, I just am so thankful and blessed that everybody's here. Whoever you get on there would be so great.
I've gotten a lot of people. People I don't even know.
Yeah, there's people I don't know too.
No, that's my slice, right?
Where do you want to meet, baby? Which one we cut?
It's my slice.
All right. Little guys out. Do we need glasses?
Oh, no, are we?
Chris shot my house.
Literally.
Kill me.
Literally.
Literally. Almost killed my.
An accident.
I never thought that day would come. It's fantastic. And I knew 5 minutes after I met Becky, she was the one. She's two out of 1 million. I have the other one. This is a fantastic day. I can't be happier. Everybody's just as happy as I am. I'm not going to stand up here any longer because I really don't have the words. And I'm not going to cry. So, cut the cake.
I don't care. Whichever.
Okay.
Ready?
Yay!
And Becky made these cakes herself.
I have. What do you mean yourself?
Let's hear it for saving $300.
I hope so, because we're right behind them.
Almost got
it. Oh,
you're mean.
Oh, let me see you.
This is video.
That was me.
Oh,
man.
She was so innocent that nobody thought she did it, and they would, grandpa said,
where would you go?
And I get the blame.
How old were you?
This guy didn't. Now Uncle Chris took out the Lincoln at age 14.
He was younger than that.
Well, 10, he was young.
You know what's really funny? Is looking at these videos years from now and seeing what hairstyles you have.
Do you think mine will change?
It will.
Be a little shinier.
I need to light behind
the eye. There we go.
Did you cake Debbie or no?
No, we were nice.
You were nice? Yeah. All of our friends.
Now, that you'll see on the videotape, and it's before what we're recording right now, but it was where they all raised their drinks and they said to Mark or something like that.
Oh, to Mark, yeah.
What is that about?
It's out back there in that group. Oh, yeah. Mark is...
Do you want to dance?
I do. I'm telling a story right there. Mark is an invisible person. And so it's kind of a joke. One of our friends is from England, and she was talking about that they were doing a mock dance, and they said, "Well, who's Mark?" And so she was saying mock though, but she has the accent, so they kept saying she was saying Mark. So everybody's going, "Who's Mark?" Nobody knew who Mark was. There's some guy named Mark, so it's just kind of a joke to Mark. So we say it every time we're, like at dance competitions or wherever we are, we just say, okay, oh, even the girls up on stage, they'll have their trophy and they'll say, to Mark! There's only, about 50 of us that get it, But a handful of them are here tonight.
So. Well, now everyone who watches this video will get it now.
Yes.
Now, did you want to say something to Mark? To Chris?
I love you, brother. Congratulations. Race on.
Okay. Chris said they're going to go dance. Do you want to go? Can I have like half of a half?
Sure. Which one?
Is that Leah Sophia necklace?
No, I don't know what it is. It's like a Claire special, you know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, really. I like Claire's. Can you put just like a little sliver of the red?
Of this? Sure.
Yeah. Smaller sliver than that.
Is that good?
Thank you. Yeah, that's
You're cool. Very welcome.
Yeah.
Do you want to do it?
Okay. That's my piece of cake. The best we can.
Everything I ever wanted, everything.
Thank you.
outside, but I don't know where they're going.
They might have left the party.
Oh, is that where I'm not going? Y'all want to say anything?
Repeat on tape.
Oh, come on, those are the best guys.
Oh, man.
Thank you.
up there instead of the kids. Lots more to take.
A lot more to drink.
A lot more to drink.
My rock, the one I hold on make time for me. I can't understand. Praise your God of earth and sky. How beautiful is your unfailing love. Unfailing love. And you never change, God, you remain the Holy One in my unfailing love. Unfailing love. And everything you hold in your hand, still you make time for me. I can't understand.